Martin Robbins has been in touch to ask us for a method of painting Tyranid hordes quickly. Tyranids are a perfect example of an army where you want lots and lots of little creatures to overwhelm your opponents with sheer weight of numbers. But of course, painting lots of little creatures can be quite time consuming, so there's a few things that you can do just to make it a bit quicker for yourself. The first thing to think about is painting your units in batches, and by that I mean what you do is paint a colour on one miniature, then move on to painting that colour on a second miniature, and so on throughout the group, so by the time you finish the last one, the paint is dry in the first one and you can move on to the next colour. Now you want to be doing groups of 10 or even 20 when you're using the method we're going to show you today, because the second thing to think about is the colour scheme. Some colour schemes are just faster to paint than others, and Hive Fleet Kraken is a perfect example of a colour scheme that's actually really fast to do when you know how. What you want to do is undercoat your miniature using Corax White, and then you'll need Seraphim Sepia to paint all the skin and the weapons. After that, we're going to dry brush it using Screaming Skull, and then we're going to pick out the carapace, first of all with Corn Red, followed by a shade of Agrax Earthshade, and finally a dry brush of Astarath Red. So starting first of all then with Seraphim Sepia, I'm going to be applying this using my medium shade brush, but depending on the size of the creature, you might want to go for a large shade brush. But what you do is just get a load of this paint onto your palette so you can judge how much you're applying at once. And when you're ready, all you've got to do is paint it all over the skin and the gun, making sure it settles nicely in all that recessed detail. Once the shade's completely dry, you're ready to apply a dry brush of Screaming Skull. You only want to do this lightly, just focusing it more around the sharper details, such as around the face just here and the joints on the limbs. Once you finish the dry brushing, you're ready to start base coating the carapace and claws using Corn Red. Now this will probably be the longest stage of the entire miniature, but just take your time being as neat as you can as you work around those light colours, and be sure to apply two thin coats. Then apply a coat of Agrax Earthshade all over the carapace and claws, just being careful not to put on too much at once so that you don't lose control of it. Once the shade's completely dry, you can highlight the carapace and the claws with a very light dry brush of Astarath Red. Now you need to be careful with this because you don't want to catch the lighter details. So what I recommend you do is just focus it on the more prominent areas. A great example is the back carapace along here and also the top of the head as well. And there we go, this termagant is now ready for basing. You could also paint in the teeth and the eyes if you want to, but that really depends on how many you've got to paint and how much time you have. But you can use this technique to paint termagants, hormigants, gene stealers, whatever horde it is you want to paint. So Martin, I really hope that helps you out and answers your question, and we'll see you all again soon.